Welcome to the world of plastic surgery, before and after. In the early 70s, Carol Ursum was young, beautiful, and ambitious.
I had my own record company. We sold all over the world. We did Bob Dylan, the Beatles, live concerts, and the very famous albums. I was studying to be a sound engineer and mix records, and I met Lindsey Buckingham, and it was pretty much love at first sight.
For 8 years, Carol lived the life of rock and roll royalty with Lindsey Buckingham of Fleetwood Mac. She did a little modeling on the side. Her love of fashion and the music scene led Carol into a second career as a costume designer, first for music videos and then for the movies.
My 30s went by in a blur, and I wore my hair in a ponytail and jeans and tennis shoes with no makeup, and I didn't care.
Today, she lives in Los Angeles with her musician husband, Martin, and their two cats.
And as I get older, I'm like, you know, it would be fun to have another 10 years of really enjoying dressing up and doing makeup and still maybe holding time at bay a little bit.
This is what I want to be after the surgery, this little fat baby face.
I think you're lying if you don't say, I wish I looked like I was 30 when you're 70. I am a 21st century girl, and I believe in Botox, and I believe in collagen. I believe in lipstick, and I believe it's just so much fun being a girl.
She also believes in facelifts. And being a 21st century girl, Carol looks for the cutting edge. She consults Dr. William Binder, renowned for his work with custom facial implants.
I'm going to talk about some sort of facial rejuvenation procedure.
I want to be 22 again.
Well, we
is
can,
that realistic, is it?
We can realistically do it from the neck up.
Okay, well, good. I'm your girl.
One of the key elements that we're going to do to make you appear younger is always focused on the midface. What we're going to do is a multi-component procedure. And you can see it better in this light. This component is going to be advanced upward and resuspended back to the position where it was. And all of a sudden, that also takes care of the fold in here as well. The mid-facial implants are going to also provide a platform for this to really stay up. That's going to restore your cheekbones that you had in those pictures when you were 22.
I want to be the happiest I can be, and that encompasses everything. That encompasses my home life, how I look, what I do for a living. I just think it all hangs together.
It will take nearly a month to create Carol's custom implants.
We are going to make a mold of your face. Okay. Are you claustrophobic?
A tiny bit, but I can bear it.
First, a plaster cast or moulage is taken of Carol's face.
Just breaking a seal.
That is very cool.
Next, CAT scan images provide data to create a 3D computer image of Carol's underlying bone structure. Layer by layer, an ultraviolet laser scans this image into a pool of liquid resin. A solid life-size model, accurate to within fractions of a millimeter, emerges. Next, Dr. Binder shapes prototype implants directly on the model of Carol's cheekbones. The prototypes are then sent to ImplantTech in Ventura, California, to be cast in silicone. Excited and anxious after a month of preparation, Carol arrives for her surgery.
I know you're a little nervous, but just relax.
Everybody. You look really bad. I'm doing big bandages on the face.
You're going to be fine. Don't worry.
This is going to be a little topographical map of your face.
Are you nervous, sweetie?
Yes.
For many patients, general anesthesia is a little scary.
This is this is your pina colada.
It's 2003. We have so many, like with Dr. Binder, so many amazing things that we, you know, the baby did, but she really doesn't.
Carol stubbornly hangs on to consciousness.
I'm looking forward to being like 70, 75, and hopefully being in London and Switzerland and bopping around and having tea parties and... I'm looking forward to that, you know, and I'm a great reader, and
Finally, she goes under. Dr. Binder makes an incision behind Carol's ear.
We're going to remove all of this skin so that we'll bring the hairline down.
He undermines the skin of her lower face.
A nice way to hide scars in general is to make non-linear incisions.
He pulls up the underlying layer of tissues and sutures them to the membrane covering the bone. He takes nearly 3/4 inch of skin from her face on each side without pulling. An incision near her eye allows him to elevate her mid-face area.
That mound of tissue, which we haven't done yet, and it's loose, and there is nothing here. It's all now back up where it was supposed to be.
He then makes tiny incisions inside Carol's mouth and creates pockets directly on her cheekbones.
That incision goes right down to bone. Really, as long as you stay on bone, you're very safe.
The cheek implants slip easily into place.
So the implant basically slips in. These implants don't move because they're a mirror image of the bone, and they just really slip into the right position.
One stitch closes the incision for each implant.
I think we achieved the softness put back into the mid-face. She had very, very delicate tissues. She had very thin skin. So however you pull has to be done with a great deal of care.
Like many people, Carol Ursum lost volume in her face as she aged.
And as you can see, this is just full hair.
She's had a facelift using high-tech custom implants to recapture her youthful looks. 7 weeks later, she's enjoying the results.
I really like the way I look with no makeup now. I mean, for the first time in a long time, with no makeup, I feel my prettiest. And that's a nice thing. That's a big change for me. In the first couple of weeks after the surgery, I would see flashes of this person that I hadn't seen for a long, long time. And now when I look in the mirror, I'm seeing the old Carol Ann, you know, from years ago, and that's neat. What do you think of Mom's new face, huh? There's an old saying, youth is wasted on the young. And by getting plastic surgery, maybe we get a little bit of a chance to have the wisdom that we gain, yet have the facade of being younger than we really are. Anyone out there sitting on the fence about doing plastic surgery, do it. Use your looks. Let it empower you.
I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille.
The die young, die pretty thing doesn't apply to me anymore. I can die old and die pretty.